That was a tune called The Vaults, which I wrote. I named it after a pub in Stafford called The Market Vaults, which is where I had my first gig when I was 16, and where I've been back many, many, many times since. Never played there again, I've just been back. It's a wonderful pub. It's full of some of my favourite characters, one of whom is the subject, in fact, of this next song. I thought I'd give you a little break from the banjo domination. Although, if banjo's not your thing, then this may not be your afternoon, to be honest. In Stafford, where I'm from, there's a great guy called Pete, who is he's a street cleaner. And whenever I've been away on tour or something and I come back to Stafford, I always find the sight of Pete very... I definitely know I'm back home, because he's quite a tall fella and he has an enormous red Mohican, which you can just see anywhere. And he's just the most fantastic guy. He's incredibly cheerful, and he kind of... I think in England, I can't speak for Australia because this is my first time here. It's not the impression I get so far, but I think in England we've slightly, in certain places, lost the art of just kind of talking to each other, regardless of whether we know each other or not. And just generally not being suspicious of other people. And I think what's great about Pete is he just kind of talks to anyone. And I think without realizing, he makes an awful lot of people's days just that little bit brighter. Particularly some of the, you know, people in Stafford who may be homeless or lonely or anything like that. He just gives them the time of day, and I think it makes them feel a whole lot happier. And sometimes he hasn't got a clue what they've been talking about for the previous 20 minutes, but nevertheless, it's good that he's made a difference. And he does overhear some fantastic conversations, and one in particular I just have to share with you was a little kid who was talking to his mum, and the exact words he used were, "Oh, I can't believe that effing thing happened." But he didn't say the F word, he actually said effing, E-double-F-I-N-G, he actually said effing. And his mum said, "Where did you hear language like that? That's appalling." And he said, "Well, Grandad told me it was better than saying king." Which I thought was great. I sort of dropped that into the song in the middle. But this is called Same Time, Different Place. It's come around again, that moment when he heads to town to watch the world and sees an unlikely source of chat with a mohawk for a hat, who's always there when it comes around again. It's come around again, the time he finds the chance to say just what is on his mind to the ever-willing ear who always seems sincere, who gives the time when it comes around again. Same time, different place, different day. Can't find a better way to say what he wants to say. She can hear as he cleans the streets, the strangest folks he meets. What are they missing? He is listening. Same time, different place, different day. Can't find a better way to say what he wants to say. That hair. All these people say what they begrudge. He's the first to listen, but the last to judge. It's come around again, the time when he said goodbye and runs along and then feels good about the way he got the time of day. And he looks ahead to when it comes around again. Same time, different place, different day. Can't find a better way to say what he wants to say. Same time, different place, different day. Can't find a better way to say what he wants to say.